Good afternoon, my dear students. I am teaching class 9, chapter 1 of chemistry, that is matter in our surrounding. In the last lecture, we have studied about what is matter, what are the physical properties of nature of matter, and what are the several four characteristics of a particle. Now, we will be learning about the solid state. There are three states, solid, liquid and gas. Out of that, we are studying about the solid state. And what are the important characteristics of a solid state? So student, you have to learn these characteristics and reasoning type of questions will be asked in the exam. So important characteristics of solid state we will be learning. So first of all, what is the first important that is, it has got definite shape. It has got, solids have got definite shape, they have got fixed boundaries. They have got fixed boundaries are there, that means edges are there, defined edges are there, and they have got fixed volume because their particles are closely fixed. So they are having fixed volume. Okay students, the second characteristics is they maintain their shape. So solids, they maintain their shape. They maintain their shape. Suppose we are applying force to a suppose I am applying force to this pen. So this pen is not being pressed. So that means this pen is a solid because it is able to maintain their shape. The third important characteristic is they do not diffuse. They do not diffuse, or they diffuse very slowly. Suppose if I try to diffuse this pen into this body, it is not able to diffuse. That means they have got rigid boundary which do not allow the diffusion to occur. But in exam, one example is there of a sponge. In exam, they ask, classify sponge as a solid. Okay, justify your answer by giving reason. Sponge has got minute pores in them. So once you press the pore, the air inside that minute pores is expelled out, and that is why sponge is considered as a solid. Now fourth characteristic is they may break under pressure. They may break under pressure or under high force. That means if I am taking a sugar crystal and I am able to crush it, that means I am applying force and the crystal is being crushed. The sugar is being crushed. So they may break by applying force. The fifth property is they have got high density. That means the molecules or the particles present in the solid state, they are very closely packed with each other. There is high molecular force of attraction between the particles. They have got high density. And what is density? Density is mass per unit volume. Mass of that particular substance in a given volume will be known as density. Now students, in the next lecture we will be studying about some of the important characteristics of the solid state. And this sponge is being asked several times, so be specific to learn the reasoning for this sponge. Okay, so students, stay at home, study thoroughly from your NCERT textbook. Thank you.